The rate at which new variants have appeared over the past few months is alarming. In the past few weeks alone, along with the insurgence of the United Kingdom B.1.1.7 and South African B.1.351 variants, more have been identified in Brazil, Ohio, and now California. The increased rates of infection and deaths in Manaus, Brazil, despite prior infections affecting 76% of the population, serve as a warning that a new variant may reinfect a population infected with an earlier strain. A similar situation may be occurring in Southern California. Here we examine their situation in more detail. One of the few vigorous SARS-CoV-2 genome sequencing efforts in the U.S. comes from Cedars-Sinai Hospital in Los Angeles. Analyzing countless samples on the lookout for the dangerous emerging variants, researchers found a strain all its own as far back as July. Only a single sample at the time, not much was thought of it. Fast forward to January and the California variant, Cal-20C, accounts for half of the analyzed isolates. Cal-20C has three unique amino acid substitutions in its spike protein. The spike protein is the part of the virus that interacts and locks into proteins from the human host cell, essentially the key to open the host to the virus. Among these are S13I and W152C in the N-terminal domain, and L452R in the receptor-binding domain. It is possible that S13I increases the efficiency of cleavage on the 12-amino peptide terminal, which may increase the volume of S-protein on the host cell. This would lead to a more infectious virus. Additionally, W152C may boost immune resistance or N-terminal domain efficiency, or something else. We need more data on these two placements before we can draw definitive conclusions from these two substitutions. The L452R substitution provides a bit clearer insight. The L452R substitutes a hydrophobic amino acid leucine for arginine. Not only is the side chain of the amino acid longer, but it is also positively charged. To understand the relationship between the receptor binding domain and the ACE2 receptor, think of magnetic puzzle pieces. Not only must the shape be an exact match for the two pieces to fit, but the magnetic poles must be aligned as well. Variation in shape or polarity may affect the fit of the pieces. L452R may improve the fit and charge complementarity of the two pieces. According to preliminary data from the Fred Hutchinson Cancer Research Center, which isolated mutation placements to test for immune escape, a mutation to the 452 placement escaped slightly more than a mutation to the 501 placement. N501Y is commonly attributed to the immune resistance of B1.1.7. If this preliminary data is any indicator, Cal-20C may be able to escape neutralizing antibodies about as well as B1.1.7. Again, more data is needed to draw any conclusions about this emerging variant, but the sooner we know the better.